Hello everyone, it's Farkad here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to build the house that I built in the climbing rope episode. Now this design was completely improvised. I came up with it on the spot. I have a feeling maybe that's the trick to making good stuff in this game. Just improvise. Now I'm using the footage from when I did the climbing rope episode. 95% of the stuff here is what I cut out, as I wasn't showing you how to build the house. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to build it. I haven't come up with a name for it. If you have a good name for it, let me know in the comments. Anyway, let's get started. So what you do is you get the custom foundation out and you go up to any pond. I'm doing this one because it's relatively flat. It's near the fertile lands. It's where I zoomed in on the intro. What I'm doing here is I'm going till it just turns into three, then I go off. I'm trying to square it up with the pond so it looks straight. What you do is get it to snap. I'm getting it to snap at two. I'm going one space across here until it just turns into two, then I move back to one. My measurements weren't that accurate when I did this. I recommend you do your measurements more accurately. And that way the roof will look much cleaner, as well as design as a whole. And I try to line it up with the other side to get it exact. The more time you spend trying to measure it, the better. Measure twice, cut once. And I think this is a place where I stuffed up. I only went two on this one and went three on the other side. That's okay. Now, a problem with custom placements with floors and custom foundations, roofs, etc., is you only have 13 placements before it maxes out. That's what I was trying to do, was max it out before it hit the 13 limit. Because then I couldn't place any more points on it, and I'd have to attach another custom foundation, which gets very confusing. Coming out on the outside, I'll wait till it snaps. Coming back over to the middle, I'll try to align it with the middle. You could be more creative on the back end that you will need to place more than one custom foundation, and trying to align it perfectly with the other one can be quite difficult. So this one's easy. If you were to make another custom foundation, it would increase the difficulty quite severely, as you'll need to align the custom foundation with the other one. Now I'm going back over a lot to make sure that I've got it as accurate as I can. It's the hardest part of it, or the most annoying part anyway. Once that's done, join it all up. Now that's the foundation done. It's probably the hardest part. And what you do is go around and place the windows and doors that you want to place. This is the part where I place the climbing rope, though I'm going to skip a lot of this stuff as I've already covered in the climbing rope video. I'll make sure that there's a link in the description for it. I'm going to place the door on each side in the same spot, here. Thought it would be a good spot for it. Looking back, I should have probably put one at the back of the house, or two. What I'm going to do is place the door here, over the pond, in the middle. If you wanted to go a single story, that's completely fine. As you can see from my measurements before, I should have went three instead of two, as it's not lining up exactly. Though I'm going to do a custom placement to try and make it look a bit cleaner. It's where I run around to each point and place the roof. And that's how it turned out. Completed that, go out to the front, and that's how it looks. Though here's what two stories looks like. I place a custom floor and just automatic mode. Next, I'm going to cut holes to make access for the custom stairs. Custom stairs are a lot more difficult to place than they used to be. I don't know, they changed something in the final release, version 1.0, and it's actually made them quite difficult to place. Unless I'm just getting senile. Now here's a little veranda part I made. I cancelled both sides of the walls here. And I get the custom wall out and I extend it across to make like a triangle for the veranda. Try and line it up as accurate as you can. Left a little log pillar there, I'm not sure why, but remove that. Now where you place the door and window on there is completely up to you. If you place the door on the side, you could have it as independent rooms. So like two rooms on each side with access to the veranda from each room. I'm just going to place the door where the living area is. And doing the exact same thing on the other side. You could come up with your own veranda design. This is just one I came up with in the moment. Now what I'm doing here is I'm placing custom stick fence, not automatic placement, otherwise it will go all the way around the house and you'll need to clear it all. It's annoying. Right on the edge to the other side. Place all the windows and doors for whatever you want around the edge. In this part here, I'm clearing the ends, the corners at the front. I'm going to place a wall straight across. This is so I can fit the tree bridge to go along the front of the house. I'm going to place a stick fence on this side, but not on the other side, because otherwise it'll block the tree bridge. So place that and build that fence. Start finishing off some of the walls. It's up to you what order you do it in. Doesn't really matter. As long as you've planned it and you don't intend to clear it later on. Trick I've learned is that if you're unsure about a wall, just leave it. Complete it later. If you've got plans to build something else there, it's better to have a think about it instead of completing it and then demolishing it. It's a waste of logs. Up here, there's not many logs. Getting them up here is a bit of a pain in this spot. Though you can get a zip line that runs over near the main cannibal village. There's heaps of logs up there. Though my season 3 playthrough, I built up here, and I had a fairly good log collecting system. Though it did take a long time to get them up here. In this part, I'm just placing a stick fence around the stairwell. Completely unnecessary. Probably more of a nuisance than anything, because you can't just drop down. You have to walk around and actually take the stairs. Though it does make it look a bit more cool and more realistic. More safe too if you've got children around. Now I've just gone outside and placed the custom stairs to the doors that I had. I'm just going around doing things in random order. I'm not doing them in a specific order. Once you place all the walls and built them all, I'm going to place the roof. Now I should have done a manual placement. It probably would have looked a lot more cleaner. But this is a problem with the measurement at the start. You're going to get strange angles on things like the roof here. Though it depends how much this bothers you. Build the roof and the house is pretty much done. Now going outside to the corner verandas, I'm going to place a pillar, just one single log pillar, to make it look more realistic. So the roof is actually being held up. It doesn't do anything, though it just makes it look better. Having the stick fence there can make it more difficult to place that pillar. On the other side, I don't have the stick fence here, so it's much easier to place. Because sometimes that log pillar will jump up on top of the fence, and it'll be annoying. But placing that log pillar, I can now place the stick fence. Now this is footage from the climbing rope and tree bridge episode. Just placing the basic walls on the corner so I can attach the tree bridge. I cover it in depth in that episode. And that's how it looks with the tree bridge. As mentioned in that video, I would have placed the basic walls more inwards, actually in the wall rather than on the edge, because then the tree bridge probably would have fit better and it wouldn't have a lip. And the tree bridge to go across the pond, simple stairs in reverse, and a simple stairs on the other side, and then attaching the tree bridge. Keep in mind this is all improvised. I'm not sure how I'd improve this design, because that would mean planning it. Improvising tends to work out better for me. Anyway, that's it. It's quite an expensive house considering where it is. There's not many trees up here. Though if you can get a lot of logs up here, it'll look a lot better. I never furnished this one, though I'm sure you could get creative with that. I actually really like the look of this house. It's quite practical and quite easy to do. It's relatively cheap as well. Though if you have a name for it, let me know in the comments. At this stage, I'm just going to call it the Pond House. Anyway, in future videos where I'm making tutorials, I might improvise the house building. It seems that's where my designs might be best, rather than planned. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Cheers.